Now let's dimension the curved wall's radius. Activate the Radial Dimension tool in the toolbox. Open its Settings dialog and display the Type and Font panel. Select the Without Center Point dimension type. Enter 1 for the marker size. Enter 2 millimeters for the font size. Select the Dimensioning Structure layer. Click OK. Click the internal perimeter line of the curved stone wall with the thick 3-pointed star cursor to set the place of the arrowhead. Click inside the entrance area to place the dimension line. Now we add some level dimensions to the floor plan. Level dimensions can associatively link to a position of an element, or they can be independent. To place some associative level dimensions, activate the Level Dimension tool from the toolbox. Open the Level Dimension Settings dialog and display the Type and Font panel. These settings define the behavior and appearance of the placed dimensions. Enter 2 millimeters for marker size. Enter 2 millimeters for the font size. Select the Dimensioning Structure layer and click OK. To make a level dimension associative, you have to specify the element you want to anchor the dimension to. This is necessary because several overlapping elements may appear on the floor plan at the point where you want to place the dimension. Select the Gravity tool on the standard toolbar and set it to Gravitate to Slab. Place level dimensions as presented on the screen. These dimensions are associative to the element, so their value will be updated if the parent element changes. Select the Gravitate to Mesh option for gravity. Place some level dimensions on the site mesh, typically around the building, and on the level lines as presented on the screen. Repeat the steps above to place level dimensions on the gallery level. Display the gallery story. Select the Gravitate to Slab option for gravity. Add level dimensions for the terrace slab and for the gallery slab as well. If the roof is visible, you can select the Gravitate to Roof option, so you can place level dimensions on the roof eaves as well. To change the marker type, open the Level Dimension Default Settings dialog. Select the appropriate marker type at the Type and Font panel. You may also change the marker type in the info box. Click OK. Add a level dimension for the eave above the terrace slab. To place a level dimension marker at the bottom eave, set the marker rotation angle to 180 degrees in the info box. Click the roof eaves over the veranda. Turn off gravity when you are done placing the level dimensions. Display the S1 building section view. Select the Dimension tool in the toolbox and display its settings dialog. On the Type and Font panel, select the Elevation Dimension type. Select the upper marker direction. Make sure that the middle option is selected for elevation marker proportion. Select the solid marker option. Enter 2 millimeters for text size. And 1 millimeter for marker size. Click OK to close the dialog. Let's dimension the right side of the building by clicking on the points of the roof, slanted wall, slab, ground slab, and foundation as shown on the screen. Double-click to finish point selection and place the elevation dimension. Now let's see how the dimension is updated if the parent element changes. Select the slanted wall in the section view. Click on its upper node to display the pet palette. Select the stretch height option. Move the cursor upwards and type 4 for height in the tracker. The height of the slanted wall is modified, and the location as well as value of the corresponding level dimension is also automatically updated.